Check
hey,
one.
I think so.
I can hear just as good as
I'm
working
out.
All right,
good, good.
Good enough
yeah.
for me.
And y'all are quicker than most bands. I'm telling you so. Are y'all excited about this? I sure am. We were just talking backstage. 25 years ago, they recorded Carrying the Tradition, the first time they ever recorded together.
Yeah.
Yeah, 25 years ago. It doesn't seem like it, but it just went by quickly. But they've been friends ever since, and of course been recording many, many times together. And of course, they just had one of the sounds that you just dream of. You know what I mean? So, I've seen the set list, folks. It's incredible. I think you're gonna like it tonight. So, after Grammys and CMA Awards and IBMA Awards, it's so good to have them on the stage, and I hope you enjoy it. Mr. Ronnie Bowman, Mr. Dan Tyminski.
Thank you, folks. I'd like to kick off a song that I wrote years ago, and it actually became the title cut of our second recording that we did. It was one called Old Country Town. It goes something like this.
All right.
Thank you.
need you, that's why I can't wait to get back home. Squeeze yourself real good and tight, and I'll be home before daylight. And you know what you got, I'm a coming home to stay.
So happy to be here. Ronnie Bowman over here. I'm Dan.
Hello, Dan.
Well, hey, y'all. Hey, Dan.
Hey, Dan. How you doing, Ronnie?
Hey, I'm good. I appreciate y'all asking. It's good to have such a great crowd here. It's good to be back here at Little John's Mountain Music Festival here. Anyway, came a long way. I've been gone since last Sunday, and been up in Maryland and all over the place. Met up with Dan. We hung out and had some supper last night. And we just worked up these songs especially for you. We hope that you like them. We're glad that you're here. He and I, we go back.
How far back, Ronnie?
Well, it depends on till they tell us to stop. Anyway, hope you enjoy this next one. This is Dan. He did a solo record years ago, and this is one that he got to do with his brother. And I am his brother, but from a different mother. And anyway, he's going to do it for you. Hope you enjoy this one called Old Love Affair.
Well, I was in love.
We'll do you a song. This is actually a song that we actually did record on. I was going to say Carrying the Tradition, but it's on Old Country Town.
It's Old Country Town.
It's Old Country Town, and this is one that we got from Don Reno and Red Smiley. And anyway, it became a duet that, you know, a lot of people asked us to sing. So we're going to sing it for you tonight and hope you enjoy one called Long Gone. I'm going to request one. This is one of my favorite songs off of Allison Krauss and Union Station's record. And Dan, he's done a lot of great things, you know, and fortunately we get to hang out and pick every once in a while. And thank God for tonight and all you people, and y'all get to be a witness. But I'm going to get him to tell you about this next song he's getting ready to do.
Well, for starters, I didn't think we could ever do this song without a banjo. We're used to, you know, this song is actually, the whole thing is all about the banjo and the group, you know, dynamic of how this thing works. Someone asked for this from Ronnie and myself. I don't know, we were playing a show up in Albany, New York about a month ago, and they said, would you try this song? And I didn't want to say no, but I was thinking it's not going to work. And then we tried it, and it was a little different, and it kind of worked. So we're going to see if it kind of works tonight. This is a song about a lazy farmer who would not hoe his corn. Yeah. about a lazy farmer who wouldn't hoe his corn. The reason why I never could tell, for that young man was always well. He planted his corn in the month of June, and by July it was up to his eye. Come September, there came a big frost, and all the young man's corn was lost.
Gotta move, gotta move, gotta, I got the hobo blues.
got the hobo blues deep down in my bones. Well, I got the hobo blues. I gotta go, gotta go, gotta got the hobo blues. Well, when I hear that whistle blow, son, I gotta move, gotta move, gotta got the hobo.
That song, and I think maybe that's why people like it. Anyway, I hope you did. We'd like to do you a tune right now, and it's kind of a standard duet, but it's one that Dan and I like.
Tuning's optional.
It's going like this. Right.
Key it off.
Yeah. You key it off, or I do? I key it off.
Kick it off. I don't even know what song it is.
We're pretty good.
Okay.
Any old town that I ran.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, one of the things I get to do with this guy that I really don't get to do with many other people that I play with is get to do songs that are original that he wrote. When I met Ronnie, oh gosh, it's been 30 years, I guess. I met him 30 years ago. I remember he had a big bunch of songs, and he was all about playing it in the right key. He was all about making up new stuff, and after we finished our stint together in the Lonesome River Band, Ronnie went on to write for Sony Music and write some country songs, and what I get to do with him, I don't get to do with anyone else, is play number one hit country songs that this man has written.
Thank you very much.
And if you would just tell him about this so I can tune just a second.
You got it. Actually, this song right here, I'm going to, you know, drop my pick and just use my fingers on this one. Yeah. And, this was, I had just gotten married, came off my honeymoon. Me and my wife, Garnet, had went to Gatlinburg. Came back and I had a songwriting session with a gentleman by the name of Don Cook, who used to produce Brooks and Dunn. And so he had an in, and long story short, me and my wife got in our first great big argument as soon as we come off our honeymoon. Now, I thought we should have been loving a little bit longer, but I guess she was over it. So I, anyway, I felt
this
so...
Never
So what happened was I thought, well, maybe I'll just cancel my songwriting appointment because I don't really feel good and I don't feel like writing. I'm too sad. I'm glad that I didn't, because I went ahead in that day, and I remember walking into the studio and some of the engineers and friends, they said, "So, Ronnie, how's married life treating you?" And I just gave it my great big North Carolina smile and said, "It's getting better all the time." Anyway, who knew? It turned into a number one song by a group called Brooks and Dunn, and really thankful for this. I hope y'all enjoy it. It goes something like this.
Yeah.
something crazy. If I ever saw you out with someone else, but when the moment came last night, I couldn't say a word. I stood there in the dark all by myself.
Something I really never get to do, since we're doing this,
is to play with someone who has multiple number one hit songs, and to let him just keep going.
That's what I'm saying. He's got more stuff.
Well, thank you very much, Stan. This is the part where, you know, he takes a little rest, but he joins in and helps me a lot. I really have to say that, I mean, I enjoy playing music with Dan Tyminski as much as anything I've ever done in my life. And honestly, if it was, I mean, he's the reason that I actually got back into playing music, because I was painting houses and I heard him sing, and so I wanted to join the Lonesome River Band. That's how I got there. Okay, and you know what?
So now what I'm gonna do,
I have to say the same thing. I was at a point where I was questioning whether or not I should still continue to drag in those big bluegrass dollars. And there was no doubt about it, when I sang with Ronnie, I knew I was doing something right. So, Big Ron?
Okay, so this is the song that I wrote with Chris Stapleton. And I mean,
not that one.
No, that's, you're thinking about the wrong one. Maybe not. Maybe
we'll do that one too. I mean,
okay, we will. But this one first. This is a song that we wrote. It was our first writing session, and we didn't get to start till 3:00. Usually, you try to get together a little early. But he called and he said, "Hey, man, I'm not going to be able to make it there for a while. Can we start, you know, maybe at 3:00 or something like that?" And by 3:00, a lot of y'all are probably thinking about getting off work. And I'm like, well, sure. So in about 20 minutes, we wrote this song. It was so fast. And then for a little while, we had this record on Billboard charts. It was the fastest rising country music song in the history of country music. And then it stayed up there at number one for 6 or 7 weeks, and I was like, oh, thank you, Jesus. And then after that, you know, when you have something like that happen for you, I mean, it's really hard to set a record nowadays. But anyway, this guy came out, and, you know, and little did we know that Garth Brooks was going to come out of retirement, and his record went to number one in 1 week. So, but anyway, I hope you like this song.
Now,
it's called Never Wanted Nothing More. $400 to a smile on mine. have a quick story that you're really gonna love and want to hang on to. So, I mean, now it's gonna start off a little bit funny because this is not a place that I hang out very often, but I went with my wife and I was walking around Bed Bath and Beyond, and which I really love that place. But and I was listening to, and I heard this guy come on, and I'm like, I can't really hear it a lot, but I know that voice. And it was Dan Tyminski on, you know, coming over the speaker. Excuse me. Well, then I was sitting around watching TV, and there was this smokeless tobacco cigarette called, I think it was Envoy or Enjoy or whatever. It doesn't matter. But what mattered was...
Inhale.
Well, yeah. Well, I
don't know what it was either.
But anyway, and I'm like, he's on a darn TV commercial. That's Dan again. Well, I really didn't know much about what was going on because it was kind of techno-electronic. But anyway... comes to find out, this is like one of the biggest songs in the world. And anyway, now it's on you, brother.
Well, this was a funny one because I got offered to do this song that was electronic dance mix.
It was called EDM, yeah.
So in your mind, you gotta be picturing that. From this guy, Avicii. Now this is, you've been to a lot of festivals, you've heard a lot of the same songs at the festivals. You probably haven't heard this one. I'll try this before you call. Hey brother.
Hey brother, there's an endless road that leads you. Sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. Hey, brother, there's an endless road.
Chris Stapleton a little while ago, and you guys are cheering. I'm pretty sure this is the song that you're... Does anybody really? Watch the ACM, the Country Music Awards? An honor that almost no one that writes songs gets to ever receive in their lifetime is to win Country Music Song of the Year.
Yeah.
We've got him right here, Ronnie Bowman.
I mean, that was so special, but they had the 15 best and worst moments of the ACMs, and the first thing they had up was the best shout out to Mom, and I felt like that was the least I could do since my mom's asked me, son, would you write me a song? And I did at 14 years old. And so that's Miss Hazel Bowman. She's passed from us, but anyway, she'll always be with me. And so wrote this with a guy in his band, Alistair Crouch at Union Station, Mr. Barry Bales. Yeah, and Chris Stapleton. And I'd like to play it for you. It goes something like this. Blame.